interactive two-way talk radio has arrived
because
the G-Man said so.
Join G. Gordon Liddy live in his own Pal Talk chat room
by logging on to RadioAmerica.org.
Then click the audio link, download your free copy of the Pal Talk software, plug in a webcam and headset,
and get involved.
Watch and listen to the show on your computer
anywhere in the world.
It's just like being in your own covert underground headquarters with 100 other Liddy fans.
So come on,
pry open your browser, sneak in quietly, and join
the G-Man in a Radio America chat room right now.
Warning. You are about
select
to enter the American
sector.
Gordon Liddy.
Booster.
Go.
Petrol.
Go.
Fight off.
Don't fly.
Iden.
Guidance go.
Peacock.
We're go, fly.
Tell you.
Go.
Control.
Go, fly.
Inco.
We are go.
Network. Go. Recovery.
Go.
Capcom.
We're go, fly.
Launch control. This is the G-Man. We are go for launch. And it is I, G. Gordon. All right, ladies and gentlemen, good to be back. I was off for Thanksgiving. Went out to Arizona where I have a home and had a bunch of my grandchildren out there, and sort of my Western children and grandchildren, and had a great time. Feeling refreshed. But I came back here only to realize that we are in trouble. The population of this country is 300 million. 160 million are retired. That leaves 140 million to do the work. There are 85 million in school, which leaves 55 million to do the work. Of this, there are 35 million employed by the federal government, leaving 15 million to do the work. 2.8 million are in the armed forces preoccupied with killing Osama bin Laden, which leaves 12.2 million to do the work. Take from that total the 10.8 million people who work for state and city governments, and that leaves 1.4 million to do the work. At any given time, there are 188,000 people in hospitals. That leaves 1,212,000 to do the work. Now there are 1,211,998 people in prisons. That leaves just two people to do the work. You and I. And you're sitting on your butt listening to me. Nothing's happening. And you wonder why we're in economic meltdown.
Sir, this letter came for you while you were gone.
Uh-huh. We are hearing now the dulcet tones of Franklin. Yes, Franklin.
To G. Gordon Liddy. Your choice of portraying the story of blatant animal abuse on your radio show today is beyond disturbing. It's frankly sickening. To top it off, for you to name the woman queen for a day is in no way funny or tongue-in-cheek. If you were looking to produce some witty banter for your show with this repulsive story, it's clear that you're desperate for intelligent listeners. And I didn't hear about this story by tuning into your show because I can't listen to you for more than 3 minutes. It's obvious that you don't care about animals. But to laugh at an account of a living, breathing creature, an elephant that feels severe pain as the result of an ignorant, greedy person who kept this animal in prison and used it for her own personal gain is very, very disgusting. Maybe you can think about contributing to make the world a better place by leaving the airwaves. Sincerely, Cindy Cranmer Taylor.
Oh, dear Cindy. Now, do I have to tell the story over there so
yes,
that the people who just listened to the radio? This was a true story. And this happened some years ago when there was a very, very popular television program. I guess it was one of the first of the so-called reality programs, Franklin. It was called Queen for a Day. And women who needed money, you know, they were desperate for money, would send their story, why they desperately needed money, into the producers of Queen for a Day. And they would judge them. And the winners would come on the program and tell their story. And then the audience would choose which one would become queen for a day, and there was a cash prize and so forth. And it was a very popular program. So one day this woman came in, and the host asked her, "Why do you need money?" And she said it was to buy a new elephant. And that certainly was unusual, buy a new elephant. Why do you need to buy a new elephant? Well, she proceeded to relate that she lived in the outskirts of a small town out in the Midwest. And she was by the road leading into town. You wouldn't want to really call it a highway. It was the road. It's the way you got into town. And she made a living by having an elephant that had a shackle around its leg onto a chain, which was then staked into the ground out there at the side of the road. And people would stop, you know, to see the elephant. And she had nearby a vending machine. You put a quarter in the vending machine, and out would come a little packet of peanuts, and you got to feed the elephant. And there was a sign saying, "Please use the peanuts only. Don't go across the road," because that was where there was a crabapple orchard or something. And the elephant liked the crabapples, but it was very bad for the elephant. "Don't feed the elephant crabapples." Well, someone came along and was attracted by the elephant, had some children. They went over, and lo and behold, the peanut machine was empty. I mean, she'd had a good day. And in blatant disregard of the sign saying, "Do not give the elephant crab apples," all the person and all the children went across the road, risking their lives, coming back with large numbers of crab apples, and proceeded to feed them to the elephant. This made the elephant very ill, just as the sign said it would. And the elephant started to moan. It was terrible. And finally the elephant just lay down on its side, moaning pitifully. And out came the woman who owned the elephant and who was on the show. And she realized immediately what had happened. And she figured that the only solution was to give the elephant an enema, which she proceeded to do with a garden hose. And she got that hose up there where it was supposed to go, and she turned on the water, which, of course, was ice cold. Now, this poor animal, an elephant down there, is getting this ice cold enema. And did not like it. And with a huge bellow, he let out their, whatever the elephants do, when they're getting an enema, and I'm very unhappy. Jumped up with such a degree of force as to pull the stake right out of the ground, and he took off down the road. Elephants can move pretty fast, especially when they're trailing a garden hose out their butt. And he ran into town. And he was just beside himself, as you might imagine. And people were diving left and right to get out of the way. They called the police. The police didn't know what to do. All they had was a handgun. They called the state police. By this time, the elephant was trampling cars, squashing them at the side of the road. The state police shot and killed the elephant using a high-powered rifle. And the poor woman said, "That is why I need to be queen for a day, because I've got to buy a new elephant." And she won. And I'm sorry, Cindy, if that upsets you. When we return, I will give you an update on the Bombay attacks. And I will now open the lines at 1-800-GG-LIDDY. That's 1-800-445-4339 for your questions, thoughts, and observations on that subject and the subject of the New Deal. Do you remember Franklin Roosevelt? You don't remember, but I remember Franklin Roosevelt, the New Deal, supposedly getting us out of the Great Depression. It did no such thing. We'll talk about that. Why? Because apparently Barack Obama doesn't know his history. Is the world unprepared for Bombay-type attacks? Is London next? What about New York or Washington? We'll take your calls in just a moment. The lines are wide open. 1-800-GG-LIDDY, 1-800-445-4339.
This is the G. Gordon Liddy Show.
Change can be very bad. That is why, in consultation with my friends at Roslyn Capital, I have armor-plated my investment portfolio with gold. Roslyn will send you a free gold investor's kit so you understand how gold counteracts volatility, how to choose it, buy it, keep it, and more than a few insider's secrets. If you are serious about defending your investments from vulnerability at a time whose only hallmark is change, I recommend you immediately to my precious metal advisors. Start by asking them for the free kit. Rosalind Capital, R-O-S-L-A-N-D, RosalindCapital.com, 1-800-679-3494, 1-800-679-3494.
Mom just turned 82. I really worry about her living alone.
My mom's 74, and this is the first year she's going to be on her own. It's pretty scary.
My dad's 88. He's in great shape, but I still need to check on him several times a day.
Each year, more and more older Americans choose to maintain their independence and live alone. But if you're a child of one of them, you worry. What would happen if they became ill, got injured, or fell, and were unable to reach a phone? The answer is a small pendant from Alert USA. This two-way personal emergency response system is meant for those times when help is needed but the phone is out of reach. The wearer simply presses the pendant, alerting our monitoring station, who then summons help to their residence. Right now, for a limited time, get the Alert USA system for just 50 cents a day. For a free brochure, call 1-800-832-1177. That's 1-800-832-1177. Act now and receive a smoke detector with free 24-hour monitoring when you subscribe. Call 1-800-832-1177.
Who's always there for you? Your mum? Maybe, yeah, but sometimes she's a bit chatty with you. Oi, when are you going to get a girlfriend business? Now, GEICO, they're always there for you. They have been for over 70 years. They insure over 8 million policyholders, and the customer satisfaction is at 97%. With GEICO service, no wonder it's the third largest automobile insurance company. Your mum might cook better, but everything else, it's a very close call.
For a free rate quote, visit GEICO.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Once a year, America's favorite tool store reduces the tools you use every day to just $1. Now through Sunday, it's Harbor Freight Tools Dollar Days. 12-foot tape measure, long neck funnel, 10-piece hex key set, just $1. Even 3-inch professional paintbrushes, 2 for $1. Hundreds of items slashed. Quality tools make the perfect holiday gift. If you buy tools anywhere else, you're throwing your money away. It's Harbor Freight Tools Dollar Days. Now through Sunday. For a store near you, go to harborfreightusa.com.
Thank you for calling Rosetta Stone for your free language learning demo CD-ROM.
Yeah, what's the catch?
Excuse me?
Your ad says I can get a free Rosetta Stone demo CD with 31 different languages. So, what's the catch?
No catch. We're so sure Rosetta Stone is the fastest, easiest way to learn a new language that we'll give you a free demo CD to try it for yourself.
Okay, but I've tried to learn a new language before and it was always too hard.
Well, Rosetta Stone is a completely natural way to learn a new language, just like you learned your first language. No tedious translation, useless memorization, or boring drills. Oh, but there is one thing.
The catch, right?
You could start speaking a new language in less than 10 minutes.
Uh-huh. Wait, did you say 10 minutes?
To get your free demo CD from Rosetta Stone, call now 1-800-339-2117. Experience for yourself the fastest, easiest way to learn a new language guaranteed. For your free demo CD, call now 1-800-339-2117. That's 1-800-339-2117.
Hi, this is Sally Field. I always thought calcium and vitamin D and exercise would keep my bones healthy, but I got osteoporosis anyway, so my doctor started me on once-monthly Boniva. And he told me something important. Boniva works with your body to help stop and reverse bone loss.
Boniva ibandronate sodium is a prescription tablet for postmenopausal osteoporosis. See our ad in Cooking Light. Don't take Boniva if you have low blood calcium, severe kidney disease, or can't sit or stand for at least 1 hour. Follow dosing instructions carefully. Stop taking Boniva and tell your doctor if you have difficult or painful swallowing, chest pain, or severe or continuing heartburn, as these may be signs of serious upper digestive problems. If jaw problems or severe bone, joint, and or muscle pain develop, tell your doctor.
I've got this one body and this one life, so I'm doing my best to build strong, healthy bones. Ask your doctor if Boniva is right for you.
Boniva, help stop and reverse bone loss. For a free trial offer, call 1-800-4-BONIVA or visit boniva.com.
Ravi Shankar on the Dobro, I think it is. It's one of those.
That's Ravi Shankar on the Dobro, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the G. Gordon Liddy Power Hour here on Radio America.
All right. That is by way of introducing a discussion of the attacks on Bombay. I think it was only about 10 men were able to kill 200 people. And I suppose we should be grateful that they didn't achieve their goal, which was 5,000 people. There's apparently five still at large. And the first thing that came to my mind is that since September the 11th, 2001, we have not had another attack here in the United States. And to give credit where I think credit is due, George W. Bush, by taking the fight immediately to the enemy over on his territory, and by playing hardball with them internationally, has preserved us from a repeat attack up to this point. Now, if there had been more attacks, everybody would be blaming George W. Bush. So I think he deserves the credit for the fact that there have not been. What this does show is that there has been no decline in the inclination of the jihadist Islamic terrorists to engage in jihad. The attempt to inflict terror upon, quote, unbelievers, meaning persons who are not Islamic, and indeed even some persons who are Islamic but not of their particular variety of Islamic, Sunni versus Shia and so on. It remains a very serious problem. And I hope that those first intelligence briefings given by the intelligence community to Barack Obama after his election curled his hair even tighter. He's not going to be able to talk these people out of it. They want to kill him. They want to kill every one of us. They want to kill the Israelis. And as we have seen, they plan it well. They train them. And then they strike. Well, let's get your attitude toward it at 1-800-GG-LITTY. Let's go to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and Rich.
Yeah, hi. How are you, Diddy?
Fine, thanks, Rich.
Yeah, this is all what happened in Bombay last week and what happened in New York 7 years ago is all the reason why we have to, I'm not saying eliminate immigration to this country, but greatly, greatly curtail it, especially from the ones who come in from these Islamic countries.
Well,
because the same thing is going to happen again here in this country. It's just a matter of when.
Well, we have a history of that sort of thing. There was the Chinese Exclusion Act a century ago.
I remember hearing about that.
Things like that. But these days, we require some indication of ill will or on the part of some of these people before we would prevent them from coming in. And there's two kinds of immigration. You know, there's legal immigration, which we should encourage, and we should encourage it only, however, from educated people who can contribute to society. Then there's the illegal immigration, which are the Indian peasants coming in from Mexico. We certainly don't need, and those, however, just continue to flow in because we do not protect our borders. And if an Indian peasant can stumble into this country successfully, I should certainly think a determined Islamic terrorist could. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the lines are open for you. Is New York next? Do you think we are prepared? How do you think we can be better prepared? Remember, these guys sneaked into India. Inja, as they call it over in the UK.
Live from Washington, you're listening to the Voice of Freedom, the Voice of Liberty, the Voice of the Nation.
This is Radio America.
IRN USA Radio News. I'm Greg Moore. Senator Hillary Clinton is expected to be named Secretary of State today by President-elect Barack Obama. Jennifer Polsoni has reaction from some New York politicians.
New York Congressman Anthony Weiner says New York's junior senator is the right choice for Secretary of State.
She not only has experience dealing with world leaders from every corner of the globe, having been First Lady and now a senator, but also having represented New York, whose diversity is renowned.
Clinton's appointment was made possible by her husband after former President Bill Clinton agreed to go public with the names of more than 200,000 people and organizations that have donated to his charitable foundation. New York Governor David Paterson is the one to name a Clinton replacement and has already said it wouldn't be him. Jennifer Polsoni, New York.
You're listening to IRN USA Radio News.
You've got spam in your email now.
Whoa!
The holiday season is here, and with it, the onslaught of email-based spam, viruses, spoofing, phishing, and spyware attacks. Keep your business safe this holiday season by installing a Barracuda Spam Firewall, the world's number one selling anti-spam solution. With no software to install and no per-user fees, it's the simplest, most cost-effective way to stop dreaded holiday spam. Call 888-ANTI-SPAM now for your free trial. 888-ANTI-SPAM or go to Barracuda.com.
You don't have to wait any longer. With Walmart's unbeatable prices, you can now upgrade to the phenomenal movie-watching experience of Blu-ray. Sharp HD TVs and Magnavox Blu-ray players have never been more affordable. And The Chronicles of Narnia, Prince Caspian, rated PG, is coming on Blu-ray and DVD December 2nd. So now, you can bring Hollywood's biggest movies home in high definition. Save money, live better. Walmart. We will match the price of any local competitor's print ad for an identical product. See store for details.
This is Dan Tullis, and I just called
Joel Clark,
one of Select Quote Insurance Services Term Life Agents.
Hi, Mr. Tullis.
Joel, how does Select Quote save you money on term life insurance?
Well, buying term life insurance is about choosing the right company. Let's say you take antidepressants or you smoke. All insurance companies are going to price that differently. Now, we'll impartially shop all the companies we represent to find you the best price.
Can you give me an example?
Sure. I just got a 40-year-old man on blood pressure medication, a $500,000 policy with a highly rated insurance company. His price? $20 a month.
Thanks, Joel. See how affordable term life insurance can be for you. Call 1-800-989-9478. That's 1-800-989-9478. Or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote. We shop. You save. Get full details on the example policy at selectquote.com/commercials. Your price could vary depending on your health and other factors. Not available in all states.
Are you worried about making money in this economy? Well, I'm not, and you shouldn't be either. Hi, I'm Laurel Engmeyer. The strategies I'm teaching right now can put new money in your bank account in the next 4 to 6 weeks.
Best-selling author and millionaire maker, Laurel Engmeyer, has personally coached hundreds of people into financial freedom. Laurel can teach you how to grow your bank account fast, even in this economy.
My experience in the first 4 months, I walked away with almost $300,000.
Did you know that fortunes are made in recessions? I can show you how to make more money this year than ever before.
Get started with Laurel's book, Millionaire Maker, and her powerful CD, Creating Massive Wealth in Today's Economy, a $75 value.
You can do this. And to get started, I'm going to give you a copy of my best-selling book and a bonus CD for free.
Just pay a small shipping fee, and you can put new money in your bank account in the next 4 to 6 weeks. Call 1-800-216-3320 for your free book and CD. That's 800-216-3320. 800-216-3320.
And now, another reason to switch to GEICO.
They say the best defense is a good offense, but when it comes to safe driving, GEICO believes a good defense is, well, a good defense. If you're 50 or older and you complete an approved defensive driving course, you could qualify for a special discount on your GEICO car insurance, up to an additional 10%. Wow, sounds more like a defensive savings course.
For details, visit GEICO.com, where 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Special discount not available in all states.
Where does it hurt?
My back.
Oh, my neck, right by my shoulders.
Introduce yourself to the targeted relief of Thermacare heat wraps.
You just put it on right where it hurts.
And feel the real heat of Thermacare penetrate deep below the surface to target your sore spots. Clinically proven to soothe and relax tight muscles all day.
Wow, I can feel it.
Right where you need it.
I can bend.
So you can keep moving.
I'm out of here.
For targeted relief, try Thermacare heat wraps and wear it where it hurts. Use as directed.
Now,
live from Radio America in Washington, D.C.,
a wartime Army officer,
a high official in the U.S. Treasury,
an FBI special agent,
an international lawyer,
a special assistant to the president,
a paratrooper,
an American.
legend.
This is the G. Gordon Liddy Show.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, here's what happened. The terrorists, using the coastline, sneaked into Bombay and it was clear that they were seeking to attack the Indian government. Indians. If they'd been after, quote, the West, end quote, you know, Americans and people like that, they'd have gone after the Hilton Hotel or something, maybe the Marriott. Instead, they chose the Taj Mahal Hotel, which is very popular with well-to-do Indians. And they struck there. And an adjacent building where there was an outpost, I suppose you'd call it, of the Lubavitch Jewish sect, Shabad. They killed everybody in there, men, women, and children. And their goal was to kill as many people as possible. The Indian government sent in its commandos, who finally were able to stop the attack. And the damage was extensive. And while it did not achieve its goal of killing as many people as it had wished, it was a tremendous blow to the Indians' sense of security. The security chief of the government resigned as a result of his perceived failure to protect them. And that's what went on. Allegedly, they trained in Pakistan, and Indians are pointing their fingers at Pakistanis and vice versa, which is nothing new. I'm sure you'll all be aware. But that's what happened. And you can just bet the farm that it will happen again and again and again. It will probably happen here, especially under the governance of President Obama, President-elect Obama now, unless and until he rids himself of the notion that he can charm them out of it. All right. Let's go to the telephones at 1-800-GG-LIDDY. That's 1-800-445-4339 here. Do you think Obama is ready for such an attack? And how do you think he would respond to it? From West Virginia, Ed.
Good morning, G-Man. Welcome back to the fold.
Thank you, sir.
You mentioned a few minutes ago that when the president-elect Obama was briefed about this incident in India, that it curled his hair, pun intended. Probably not, because he's getting the same people with his administration as what Clinton had in his, and there was a lot of holdovers in the Clintons that that came from the Jimmy Carter regime. All three, Clinton and Carter, were very hard on the intelligence communities as far as their funding and resources, plus the general overall lack of security in the White House. It leaked like a sieve. And this comes from people who worked there at the time with whom I served in military intelligence. Mm-hmm. So if Obama is going to be consistent with the other two regimes, and I think he will, I think he isn't going to pay a whole lot of attention to what the intelligence people have to say. And unless it turns into something really crazy, like if something like what happened in India happened here, he would be more inclined to consult with his political advisors more than anything, so as to take a to take an action that would be more politically expedient rather than actually addressing the problem.
Well, I think you're right about Obama's being devoted to political expedience. I mean, that's how he got where he is. I mean, that's his whole life, his political experience. Whether he will pay any attention to the intelligence services or not, I don't know.
I think he'd only do it unless he absolutely perceived that he had to.
Well, probably so. I mean, but he, up to now, his public pronouncements have led people to believe that he thinks he can jawbone these people.
Well, first of all, he's deceived himself, and he's hoping that we're all just as deceived as he is.
Well, 50-some-odd million of us weren't. Didn't vote.
Well, maybe in 2 years we can turn this thing in a different direction.
Well, let's hope so.
Well, we're going to have to, because if it's half as bad as what it was around in Clinton's time, in which I served and I saw all this kind of stuff, the chances for a disaster are extremely good.
Yeah, I would have to agree with you, Ed. And thank you for listening and for calling. All right, let's go down to Tennessee and Tom.
Mr. Liddy, gung-ho greetings.
Good to see you, Hello. Tom. You're on the air.
I agree with that last caller with regard to Obama's political expediency. As you know I've called you for years, I served on a counterterrorist team in the Air Force, and it seems to me that, first of all, the Indian government failed to recognize that incident for what it was, or, and I hope this is not the case, tried to keep it low-key as a political spin device, and that's what I'm concerned that Obama would do. And so that's...
Well, it's pretty hard to keep something like what happened in Bombay low-key.
Well, the Clinton administration had significant success spinning the Flight 800 incident to say that it was not shot down when it was.
Well, there are conspiratorial theorists who believe that. There are also a lot of people who don't.
Well, that's true. But if I may change the topic for a little bit on aviation, knowing that you're a pilot, today is Civil Air Patrol Day, and that's a day that does not get a lot of attention. And part of that is because the lamestream news media tends to focus instead on World AIDS Day. And so they focus on lobbying in favor of a disease instead of patriotic volunteers that go out and save lives at great cost to themselves, both financially and personally.
Yes, the Civil Air Patrol does very good work, and we should praise them.
My last assignment in Civil Air Patrol was in your old stomping grounds. I was commander of the Dutchess County Cadet Squadron.
I'll be darned. Well, yeah. Good for you. I'm glad to know that you were. Well, thank you very much, Tom. I appreciate hearing from you. And we just got an email in from Gordon Wheeler, who's from White River Junction in Vermont. He said, Gordon, Kashmir is a powder keg and has been ever since Mahatma Gandhi lost the battle to keep India unified. The Pakistanis living in this country are a hardworking and generally honest people. But God save us if radical Islam's grip on Pakistan gets any tighter. I think Obama is not ready to lead in any time of crisis, and I pray that gun laws will be sufficiently relaxed so that we might defend ourselves from such bad guys as we've seen in Bombay. Love the show. Signed, Gordon Wheeler, White River Junction. Well, I don't know that the gun laws are going to be relaxed. I think we would be very fortunate to be able to keep them pretty much as they are. Certainly, the Brady Bunch and the rest of the anti-gunners are going to be pushing Obama and the Democrats in Congress for more anti-gun legislation, which, of course, will not be aimed at the bad guys, the criminals, all of whom who wish to have guns have them. It'll be aimed at the honest citizens of this country seeking to enjoy their Second Amendment rights, recently confirmed as an individual right by the Supreme Court of the United States in the Heller case. Okay, we're going to take a quick break.
You know, sir, there was a tragedy inside this tragedy as well, if you'll permit me to mention.
Yes.
All of the news reports, now that we're really learning what happened there in Bombay, all of the news reports confirm that the security guards, the police officers, the transit security guards, many of those men armed, all of them armed, really, many of them very well armed, were playing dead during these attacks. Many were running and hiding. They were running from the perpetrators. They were hiding under tables and chairs. A number of police officers in a police cruiser faced with these terrorists decided that they would play dead inside the car, inside their cruiser. Did very little to help the people in a time of crisis.
Yeah, well, the fact that you have a firearm doesn't mean that you've got the courage to use it. It's an extraordinarily shameful thing.
And it was very widespread.
Yeah.
And that's part of why the Indian people are so upset. They're really, really upset because the word got around very fast that the security people were running, hiding, and playing dead and were not engaging the terrorists.
Yeah. Well, the Indian people have the right to be disgusted in that instance. All right, let's take a little break. And when we come back, I want to talk about this New Deal mania that seems to be gripping the mainstream media and other believers in the messiahship of Barack Obama.
This is the G. Gordon Liddy Show. Have you won a lawsuit? Are you collecting a series of future structured settlement payments? Would you like to turn those payments into cash now? We can help you. Contact SSI today. If you have a lawsuit, an insurance claim, or any other claim or future series of periodic payments, we can help too. Contact SSI now. We can even help if you're a senior and want to cash in your life insurance policy and are reluctant to surrender at the current value. We'll provide you with the most competitive, professional, and prompt service available, bar none. Our courteous and patient staff will help guide you through every step of the process. Why wait for your money when we can help you get it now? Contact SSI now. Visit us online at futurepaymentsnow.com. That's futurepaymentsnow.com. Or call us toll-free at 800-783-1975. 800-783-1975. Call now, 800-783-1975.
Your wealth is the product of your productivity. Your productivity is a function of your personal health and ability. What opportunities have you missed as you waited to call Nature's Youth? Call 1-800-478-7111 today and get a free one-month supply of youthful sleep, compliments of me, the G-Man, with any order. Carpe diem, seize the day, today. Call 1-800-478-7111. 1-800-478-7111.
This is Rebecca Mathias, president of Motherhood Maternity. Did you know that in America today, 1 in 8 babies is born prematurely, and more newborns die from premature birth than any other cause? Well, solutions are within our grasp. Together with the March of Dimes, we can find the causes of premature birth. It's time for us to do more to help moms have healthy, full-term babies. Join the March of Dimes and moms across America. Sign the petition for preemies at marchofdimes.com/petition.
Is your child disrespectful, defiant, or obnoxious? Does everything turn into an argument with your kid? I'm behavioral therapist James Lehman. I'll help you turn your child's behavior around right now with a total transformation.
after the total transformation. There's no more arguing, no more lecturing, no more back-talking. Now when I ask him to do something, he does it.
We've learned verbiage from the Total Transformation Program, and it's almost like magic. If you say those words, they stop arguing.
Defiance, back-talking, lying, acting out in school, even problems with ADD and ADHD. The Total Transformation will help you solve even the worst behavior problems. I guarantee your child will listen to you again, and you get peace and sanity back in your home.
Call now and get How to Turn Your Child's Attitude Around in 1 minute or less free with your order. 1-800-801-6378. 1-800-801-6378. Call now. 1-800-801-6378. 1-800-801-6378.
I'm Ed Hanway, Chairman and CEO of Cigna Corporation. In America today, 1 in 8 babies is born prematurely, and more newborns die from premature birth than any other cause. Solutions are within our grasp. Together with the March of Dimes, we can find the causes of premature birth. It's time for us to do more to help moms have healthy, full-term babies. Join the March of Dimes and moms across America. Sign the petition for preemies at marchofdimes.com/petition.
We're here today with Paul Dow of Timeshares Only. And, Paul, you've got some terrific news for timeshare owners.
That's right. In the next 6 months, over $3.5 billion of timeshares will be sold.
So this is the perfect time to sell.
Exactly, which is why you need to get your property into our network, and if you call us right now, you'll also get a $500 shopping spree absolutely free.
$500 free?
Yes, just for posting your property with Timeshares Only. And when you do sell your property, you'll get cash. It's a double bonus. You can't lose.
Except if I don't call.
Hey, over 10 million people will be looking to buy a timeshare. So we need your property now.
The number to call now is 1-800-921-0714. That's 1-800-921-0714. Turn your timeshare into cash and get a free $500 shopping spree.
And if our lines are busy, please keep calling.
That number again for timeshares only is 1-800-921-0714. That's 1-800-921-0714.
Do you suffer from cold sores? Relieve One-Day Cold Sore Symptom Treatment is out to prove how fast it really works. If you suffer from those nasty sores, try Relieve and find out for yourself if Relieve works really fast for you. Relieve is spelled R-E-L-E-E-V. It's easy to find and is in all major drugstores. So if you get cold sores, remember to get Relieve now and keep it ready to use the moment a cold sore attacks.
In Washington, D.C.
This is the G. Gordon Liddy Show.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. From Illinois, John, you're on the air.
Hey, John. Hey, G. Gordon. It's an honor to speak with you.
Pleasure to speak to you, John. How may we serve you, sir?
Hey, first of all, I just want to thank you for the service that you and your family have given our country.
Well, my children's service was a lot more substantial than mine. Thank you very much.
Well, first thing, I just want your opinion on a couple things. One of them is, do you think this attack in India may be like a practice run, since India may have been kind of an easy country to get into, and there was a few people that did it, that they'll take this and go back and reevaluate what went right, what went wrong, so that they, next time they can maybe get their 5,000 or more killed?
Well, you always, okay, go ahead.
And I'm sorry, my second opinion or question is that if these guys came from Pakistan, do you think that now that we will be able to get into Pakistan, or somebody else will be able to get into Pakistan to root out some of these cell groups?
Okay, first of all, you always have an after-action report and analysis of what went right, what went wrong. I mean, you do that routinely. I think this was directed at India. I don't think it was a practice run, but I do think that they will analyze carefully what went well and what did not. We're trying to come to an agreement with the Pakistani government to have them turn a blind eye to some of our activities in those areas of the Pakistani frontier that are not really responsive to the central government, the warlord territory, in our attempt to get Osama bin Laden. But I think that that's about the best we can hope for right now. At any rate, thank you very much, John.
Well, thank you. It's an honor to talk with you.
Thank you, sir. Okay, now, I lived through the Great Depression, and, you know, I'm aware of this myth that Franklin Delano Roosevelt, New Deal, brought us out of it. What concerns me is the fact that Obama shows signs of buying into the myth. George Will says that early in what became the Great Depression, John Maynard Keynes was asked if anything similar had ever happened. Yes, he replied, it was called the Dark Ages, and it lasted 400 years. It did take 25 years, until November 1954, for the Dow to return to the peak it reached in September 1929. So caution is sensible concerning calls for a New Deal. The assumption is that the New Deal vanquished the Depression. Intelligent, informed people differ about why the Depression lasted so long. But people whose recipe for recovery today is another New Deal should remember that America's biggest industrial collapse occurred in 1937, 8 years after the 1929 stock market crash, and nearly 5 years into the New Deal. In 1939, after a decade of frantic federal spending, President Herbert Hoover increased it more than 50% between 1929 and the inauguration of Franklin Roosevelt. Unemployment was 17.2%. I say 8 years of this administration. We have just as much unemployment as when we started, lamented Henry Morgenthau, FDR's Treasury Secretary. Unemployment declined when America began selling materials to nations engaged in a war America would soon join. In The Forgotten Man, A New History of the Great Depression, Amity Shales of the Council on Foreign Relations and Bloomberg News argues that government policies, beyond the Federal Reserve's tight money, deepened and prolonged the Depression. The policies included encouraging strong unions and higher wages than lagging productivity justified, on the theory that workers' spending would be stimulative. Instead, corporate profits, the prerequisites for job-creating investments, were excessively drained into labor expenses that left many workers priced out of the market. In a 2004 paper, Harold L. Cole of the University of California at Los Angeles and Lee Ohanian of UCLA and the Federal Reserve Bank of Minneapolis argued that the Depression would have ended in 1936 rather than in 1943 were it not for policies that magnified the power of labor and encouraged the cartelization of industries. These policies expressed the New Deal premise that the Depression was caused by excessive competition that first reduced prices and wages and then reduced employment and consumer demand. Well, here we go again. A New Deal would vindicate pessimists who say that history is not one damn thing after another. It's the same damn thing over and over. Roosevelt's efforts did not stop the Great Depression. World War II stopped the Great Depression. And let's hope we don't have a repeat of something like that. All right, that's it for this hour. After the news, the lines are open for your calls.
Liddy.
Radio has never sounded so red, white, and blue. This is Radio America.